Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. NMR stands for nuclear magnetic resonance. NMR is the single most prevalent method for analyzing molecular structures in organic synthesis. The term nuclear in NMR can refer to many different nuclei, including carbon-13, fluorine-19, nitrogen-15, among many others. For our discussions, we will focus on the 1H nucleus. Most people call this proton NMR. Note that we refer to nuclei not just by the element, but also by a specific isotope. Because organic molecules are full of hydrogens, mostly the H1 isotope, we can learn a lot about a molecule even if we only focus on the hydrogen atoms. How do people identify and recognize objects? Well, mostly by sight. We use traits like color, shape, and size to distinguish objects. These traits do not work well in the world of small organic molecules. Small organics mostly fall into two categories: clear colorless oils or white solids. Therefore, we need something else to try to help us tell one molecule from another. That something includes methods like NMR. NMR data are collected from a sample using an NMR spectrometer. A complete NMR system normally consists of a large magnet, this box with a coil of wire to represent an electromagnet, another box that generates signals for the magnet, this is an electronics cabinet, and a computer to display what's going on. A tube, and here's our tube, holds a sample of our molecule, and there's our sample, and the tube is dropped into a magnetic field. By seeing how radio waves interact with the sample, one can get something called an NMR spectrum. On the bottom of the screen is a graph, which is a simulated spectrum generated by a wonderful NMR simulator available on nmrdb.org. The spectrum is for a molecule, a common solvent called ethyl ether. Notice that ethyl ether has two different kinds of hydrogens in the molecule. The hydrogens on the CH2 groups and the hydrogens on the CH3 groups. Those two types of hydrogens show up as two sets of peaks. A different molecule would have a different pattern and different number of peaks. This may seem cryptic now, but with a little practice, anyone can look at a spectrum and make a quick determination of whether a chemical structure matches an NMR spectrum.